my next guest. A huge star. A small person, but a huge star. American entertainment legend. Leading lady in the 50s. Singing in the Rain, you remember that? Oh, we'll hear it again in a minute. Now, more recently, she's appeared in Will and Grace. Tremendously successful television here and in the States. Her first theatre appearance in the UK for 34 years, with a tour of her one-woman show. Give the game away. The show is called Debbie Reynolds, Alive and Fabulous. Proof, if proof were needed, here she is. Oh, wonderful to see you. Wonderful to see you, Debbie. Now, it's been...
You look like a big lollipop.
Yeah. Look, can I press you to an Easter egg?
Oh, yes, please do. Lay me anything.
Well, there you are.
Perhaps, give me anything.
Perhaps we'll wait for a gap in the conversation. If things get a bit stilted. You
can, yeah. Always.
Yeah, there you are. You'll find that it's hard on the outside, but engagingly soft in the middle.
Oh. Probably like my second husband.
They're not bad, are they?
Very good.
Oh, yeah, good.
Oh, they're wonderful.
It's always a sign of a good interview when you can carry it on while people are eating at the same time. Now, look, why is it taking you so long to come back here? Because I know this one-woman show of yours, you've toured hither and yon, and why take so long to get back here?
You know, I tour, like, in the United States, like, 42 weeks a year.
Gosh. Shouldn't have had that egg.
This is really good. I don't know. I just decided. Well, I was here in 75. They said, I thought I was 74. They say 75. At the Palladium.
Mm-hmm.
And I had a wonderful time, and I had a great audience. The audiences were sensational. And I loved it, and I don't know why I was just so busy. Well, see, I was trying to stay alive, because now it's been such a long time that I am alive. And I love that name. They said, Debbie, we're going to call the tour Alive and Fabulous. I said, well, the Alive is working. I don't know, Fabulous yet. I haven't seen the reviews. Are you folks going to come? Yeah. And you'll see if I'm fabulous. Well, it's fabulous that I'm still alive, I say.
We can see you're pretty fabulous
and
from
Terry,
where we're sitting.
And Terry, you're looking good too, honey.
Yeah, that'll be the clean living, of course, in my case.
It's clean. Yeah.
And look at you. You don't remember, but I interviewed you on television when the world was younger, and you looked exactly the same as you do now.
Oh, it's very sweet. That's not true. It's not true, but it's nice to think that. Anyway, it's a long time ago. But, you know, it's still nice to be here. It's wonderful when people look at you and say, Debbie, you look fabulous. You know, you look so great for considering that you're still alive. It's really nice.
Do you ever get anybody saying, Debbie, isn't it time you took a rest?
Well, people ask me why I don't want to retire, but I wonder what you or I would do if we were to retire. I would be so bored, you know. I wouldn't like that at all. I like entertaining. I like singing and dancing and doing all the fun things that show business allowed me to do. And I have a wonderful daughter, as you know.
Yeah.
Princess Leia.
She wrote that book about you, which was not exactly flattering. And now she's your next-door neighbor.
See, it's not really about me, Postcards from the Edge. She's a writer, so she wrote a book about a crazy lady, and they, people think it's me.
How could they get a silly idea like that?
I don't know. It's because I am a little eccentric, and I'm not the average mother, you know, baking cookies and the average thing like that sort of thing. I've always been in show business, and so my family are used to that. Carrie's used to that. She learned how to cook on, especially because I don't cook. I don't plan on ever learning how to cook. No, I like to eat. I don't want to cook.
Me too. Are you
all leaning... the shopping and all the wobbly carts and everything.
No, you're
and
leaning against everything. An open door with me there.
I just like to eat the wonderful food delivered. Mm.
That's the principle on which
Debbie,
my marriage stands.
That's right.
So let's go back a little bit to when you were young. When did you actually start? We may have heard this story before, but how old were you when you took to the boards?
Well, I was 16 years old when I started. I was just a normal girl. I don't think I was ever normal, but I was just an average girl going to school, and I wanted to be a gym teacher. And no one in my family is in show business, so I decided to enter one day a beauty contest for a free blouse and a scarf, because I didn't have that. I mean, you know, when you don't have any money, we were really poor. Was your family poor?
No, we're tremendously wealthy.
You were always rich.
Yes, no, that's why I don't mind retiring. I'm living.
Are you royalty, dear?
I'm nearly, yes.
Should I call you sir?
I wish you would. Too few people do, I'm afraid.
I will, darling. And well, I entered the contest, and I won the contest. And then a talent scout was there, and they did a screen test of me, and they asked me why I wanted to be a movie star. And I said I don't, because I didn't. I mean, I don't know why I was making the test. And so they liked me. They thought I was a cute little funny thing. And subsequently, I went on to MGM Studios, this big studio, and they put me in Singing in the Rain. Yeah. My life changed, you know, overnight. I was just like a princess story. I was a very lucky girl.
Yeah, and you were always cast as perky and wholesome.
Well, I don't know, perky, but I guess that's what you'd call me. The girl next door.
Yeah.
Well, that's what I was and am still, even though I'm an old perky.
Well, you don't look it from where I'm sitting. That's all I can say without being sycophantic.
Well, your eyes are getting bad.
You look terrific. Yes, no, exactly. I am fading fast.
This show is good, you know that? All the singing and all the music, it's wonderful. I've been listening backstage.
Really?
Yes, it's great. The whole band is sensational. Everybody's just singing away out here, and nobody's singing with me. Well, I wanted someone to sing, you know, accompany me doing anything, you know, like...
Well, you are going to sing.
I'm
going to make you sing.
Oh, okay.
I'm not yet.
Are you going to sing with me? No. Are you girls going to sing with me? Oh, darn. Well, I'll come back again.
Look, tell me about the dancing, because you danced, perhaps the only woman who's danced with Fred Astaire and Gene Kelly. Yeah. Of the two, who was the easiest or the most demanding of it?
Well, I would just say Gene Kelly is the most... they're equally great, you know, but Gene Kelly was my teacher, and I was just a kid, and I had never danced before Singing in the Rain, so you can imagine, here I was, 17 years old, and thrown in to the picture with Gene Kelly and Fred Astaire. Yeah. I mean, Donald O'Connor, so they said, keep up with them. You know, that's very hard to do. So he had to be tough on me in order for me to learn, but I think that's why I'm still here. Alive and fabulous. It's because Gene Kelly was tough on me, but he taught me really well. I mean, you have to work really hard to get any place in this day and age or in life, so Gene Kelly was a tough teacher.
I haven't done a hand's turn all my life.
You haven't worked hard at all?
No.
It's because you make it seem easy.
No, don't be deceived. I want to hear about your one-woman show. Before we're going to play Singing in the Rain in a minute, just to bring your memories back. This one-woman show, what form does it take?
Well, they call it In Concert today, you know. It's like Liza Minnelli does and Bette Midler does. And it's like Judy Garland used to do, you know. It's a woman on stage, and I do... It's sort of autobiographical. I mean, I go back and I tell all the stories of... You know, I was in the golden era, so I got to meet, you know, Katharine Hepburn and everybody, you know. Why, when you meet great stars, you get to work with... And Mae West. Oh, I loved Mae West. She was a very sexy girl. So I get to do my impressions of all the great stars. And Jimmy Stewart I worked with. Oh, you know, Jimmy, well, that's a whole different way of talking, you know. And we haven't got time to do Jimmy, because... He takes a long time to tell a story. So I've had this wonderful career of working with all these great stars. So I tell stories about, naturally, all the Frank Sinatra. I got to make a movie with Frank Sinatra. And that was wonderful fun, and he was a great guy. And he advised me early on not to marry a singer. So, of course, I didn't listen. And... I've just had this wonderful... Gregory Peck. I worked with Gregory Peck, Jack Lemmon, Dick Van Dyke, all the great stars. I've had a wonderful time doing all this. So anyway, I do a lot of impressions. I do tribute songs. It's a variety show, so I do a lot of everything. Stephen Sondheim songs of all New York, you know, all the shows tunes and things like that, Gershwin songs, and a tribute to Judy Garland, I sing her songs, and a medley of the 40s, Count Basie, Glenn Miller, and Cab Calloway, and a jitterbug. And you want to do a little jitterbug?
No, I've got a bad knee. Tell me this.
Chicken, where, huh?
Chicken. Chicken. Well, it's Easter. Where, so where does the energy come from?
Were you ever dancing? Did you ever dance?
I was born to dance.
You were born to dance, but have you ever danced?
Not with a bad leg.
Not really.
Look, I tell you what, we're going
I tell you, Mr. King brought me here, you know, because I haven't been here in such a long time. Mm-hmm. And David King, the producer, and he's the one that called me and he said, so Debbie, why don't you come and play the Apollo? Because first I'm going to Norwich, which I had to learn how to pronounce because it says a W in the middle, but you can't say it. You can't say Norwich.
Look,
it's Norwich.
Don't start criticizing the British as soon as you get here.
No, well, they told me not to say the W, so I won't.
Don't.
I had to learn how to memorize some of the, and some of them I can't say, like, land, don't know, or something.
That's why this show is called Weekend Wogan. And you, of course, you're going to last until hell freezes over yourself, aren't you?
Well, I hope I last a long time.
Well, you're doing pretty good so far.
Yeah, I want to just go out, you know. I want to just drop dead on the stage till I, you know, then I'll have myself stuffed like Trigger.
Well, there's little chance of that. Because you've done a bit of television lately, haven't you? Will and Grace, very successful show.
I did a television show, Will and Grace, which everybody seems to enjoy. I don't know here in this UK.
Yeah, we do. Yeah.
So, you know, it's very funny show. And I play Grace's mother, sort of a we don't get along, you know. Well, most daughters and mothers and daughters have little disagreements once in a while, like my daughter and I have little disagreements. You know, in Grace's, there were some funny lines. They always wrote me funny lines. I said, look, Grace, no panty line, no panties. So the mother was kind of eccentric. I think they wrote it about me.
No, there's nothing eccentric about you.
I admit that I don't want to be eccentric. I just think that I am myself. You know, I'm just. I was born April Fool's Day, so why should I be any different than?
Well, we must wish you a happy birthday. Only a couple of days ago.
Yay! Happy birthday to me.
It's a great pleasure. Now, you have a huge collection, they tell me, of Hollywood memorabilia.
I do. I believe, you know, all the great stars, Betty Davis and all the Katharine Hepburn and all the great stars shouldn't be forgotten. So I wanted to create a motion picture museum with all their costumes. So I started collecting when they had these awful auctions and they just sold them off really willy-nilly, like for Halloween costumes and terrible. So I started buying, and I have about 5,000 costumes. The Marilyn Monroe costume, you know, that she wore over the subway where a little panty showed. And who knows what else, but we weren't close. And I have the ruby red slippers, you know, from Wizard of Oz. And the little gingham dress.
You're sitting on a fortune there, aren't you?
Yes. Well, I've spent a fortune. I wanted to save it because I think that, well, see, you know, here in the UK, you believe in preservation. In Europe, all of Europe. But in America, we just throw things away. I don't know why we do that. You know, it's a very silly and thoughtless way. And so I hope that I get it done in my lifetime. I hope that I get to have that done because I bought all the furniture and the chandeliers and the cars.
So it'll be a museum with you when if the day ever comes when you pass on, with you stuffed, standing in front.
Well, I don't really care about me. But I will be in there because of Singing in the Rain, I think. But I bought it for the others, Cary Grant and James Cagney, and all the great, you know, great stars that we love so much. And I never want them to be forgotten. So that's, and Marlon Brando, and Johnny Depp, all the young ones. Oh, goes all the way back from silent films, you know, right up to now. So The Pirate knows all the way back to, you know, Charles Laughton we have, and silent screen stars, Laurel and Hardy,
Charlie Chaplin. You're going to need some place as big as the Victoria and Albert Museum to get all these things.
Well, as a matter of fact, they asked me if I would loan them about 20 of my costumes.
Wonderful.
They're having a big showing of Hollywood retribution or whatever. What is that? Some big word.
And Marmalade.
What's it?
That's a big one.
Some big showing. Oh, is that a good word? All
Marmalade.
Right. And so I'm going to do that. I'm going to loan them 20 of my costumes.
Well, now look, much as I'd love to chat to you forever, they're going to throw me off the air about 1 o'clock. So can I just say that we're delighted to see you here again. I know that you're a live and fabulous thing. Where are you going to next? You're going to be in the Apollo Theatre.
I'm at the Apollo April 28th through May 9th. Hmm. And at Warwich on the 7th.
Norwich.
Norwich.
Not Warwich.
No,
Norwich.
Norwich.
Yeah.
Norwich. Right there on the 7th. Right, next week, you know, I'll be there. Well, I'll be here all together about 3-4 weeks.
Well, we're delighted to come to see us again.
Thank you. Good to see you after all these years.
Yes, I know.
I'm glad you're still here and alive and fabulous.
I can return the compliment 100 times over. Now, I know you're going to sing for us.
You want me to sing Tammy?
We want you to sing Tammy.
Sing my only hit. Shall I sing my only hit?
Please do.
Do I get another mic?
You get up there, if you like, and stand before the people and smile. Debbie Reynolds.
Aren't you all sweet to say hi? And you might remember this little song. It's my only hit. I hear the cottonwoods whispering above. Tammy, Tammy, Tammy's in love. The old hooty owl, hooty hoos to the dove. Tammy, Tammy, Tammy's in love. Does my lover feel what I feel when he comes near? My heart beats so fabulously. You'd wish that he were here. Wish I knew. If he knew what I am dreaming of. Tammy, Tammy, Tammy's in love. Whippoorwill, you and I know. Tammy, Tammy, can't let him go. The breeze from the bayou keeps murmuring. Tammy, Tammy, you love him so. When the night is warm, soft and warm, I long for his charms. Let's sing like a violin. If I were in his arms, wish I knew if he knew. Thank you, Jerry.